think you were the little kid sitting on the porch unable to play.
Yeah. Yeah.
How do you feel this week?
I'm the little kid out of the yard this week. I'm down the street right now. I'm ready to play.
What does that mean to you to get back in it?
Said it again.
What's that mean to you to get back in it?
I mean, getting the groove. It's regular season now. We went through preseason. We had to do a couple of things with guys that are not here anymore. So getting in with the guys that are here for sure and gelling and working together. That's what I mean by getting back in there.
What was it like to watch the game the other day?
Oh, I had to watch it in the basement. My wife sent me down to the basement. All the yelling and screaming and everything. She sent me down to the basement. But it was an exciting one, man. They finished. They did good out there and got the job done.
How difficult is it to watch, though, and not be out there playing?
Ah, man, it's real difficult, real difficult, because you're sitting at home, you're looking like, man, I would have went that way, or man, I would have did this, or man, I would have done that, or you see where a couple guys missed a couple sacks, you're like, oh, man, you had it this close. I was texting guys during the game and everything, so halftime, they had a couple messages from me for sure.
To make it more exciting, coming into a situation where the front four was so dominant in that first game to help carry that on into the second game?
Oh, yeah, for sure, man. I just got to come bring whatever I bring to the table because I know those guys are going to get after it. You got Chick, you got Foley, you got Sholo. All those guys are working hard on the inside. So I just got to bring whatever I bring to the table and help match whatever they're out there doing.
What's working for the inside as far as quarterback sacks are concerned? I mean, you had pretty good preseason, and then Jermaine and Keith were able to knock down sacks against Edmonton. Is it just that things opening up for you guys?
We would love to hog all the credit. Yeah. Since we don't shine that much, but you got guys like Chick on the outside. They're doubling them, three people going over there, four people going over there, so it's leaving a lot of room for us to make plays with him on the outside and Foley on the other for sure.
We talked about the impact he could have. Is that what you're seeing right now? It's kind of benefiting you guys in the inside and you're able to take advantage of that?
Oh, definitely, because they're going to have to do something to stop him. I mean, as far as I've seen, one man can't stop him yet, so I think so.
So Sholigan's got two sacks. Is he letting you guys know that he's leading you guys in the sack department?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I think they switched his name to Boss Hog. He's on his locker and everything right now.
Knowing how competitive Todd Howard likes to keep things on the defensive line, is that just healthy competition that, you know, keeps up on you guys and you have to chase him down now within this one unit?
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's definitely healthy. It's like a good pressure. When you got a coach that wants you to be better, he doesn't really let you get comfortable or settle for whatever's there. Like, you can make a play in the backfield, tackle, whatever. He'll tell you, you didn't have proper technique. You stepped wrong. So he's one of those type guys that'll stay on you to get the best out of you for sure.
Nice is going to have T. George back this week.
Yeah, I mean, I thought Coleman did a good job last week for us, and he did all preseason, but it's definitely great to have a guy like that out there, you know, and T. George is a good energy guy. He's a guy out there who's going to be going, you know, flying around, and I'm excited to see him playing inside, you know, exclusively against against the guards. He's got a really big quickness advantage. I think you're going to see some good things out of T. George this year.